We'll move on to OP36, association between toxoplasmosis and schizophrenia, preliminary findings of a case-controlled study. Authors are Dayabandara LRM, Galhenage J, Pereira I, Gange Y, Dayananda S, Gunatilaka H, and Gunavardhana S. The paper will be read by I. Pereira.
Thank you, madam. Good evening, dear all. Welcome to the presentation. Association between toxoplasmosis and schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is a major psychiatric illness with multiple symptom domains, including behavioral, positive, negative symptoms, and much more. And these symptoms can actually affect each and every aspect of the patient's life, which can lead to detrimental outcomes. To make the matter worse, we still do not have a complete understanding about the underlying etiopathologies of this devastating illness. However, recently, the neurodevelopmental anomaly theories, the association between NMDA receptor pathway abnormalities and schizophrenia has been given much interest. So we need to explore more on these theories in order to understand the underpinning causes. Also, we need to know what is broken in order to repair it. Also, to find out new treatment targets, as well as to, if possible, to see the possibility of the prevention even in these major psychiatric illnesses. So having those in mind, we found out some interesting findings throughout the literature, where the maternal infections, including toxoplasmosis associated with the schizophrenia in the offspring, as well as the recent studies has shown the toxoplasmosis proteome has massive overlap with the NMDA are receptor subunits, which again points towards the previously told theories. So toxoplasmosis is an intracellular protozoan, which can affect humans by all these stages. But what is interesting is that its dormant cycle can hide inside the central nervous system cells and can come out time to time and can give rise to the production of antibodies against it, which again can involve in the NMDA receptor pathways. So it is highly prevalent all over the world, and actually in previous studies in Sri Lanka, it has shown that up to 60% in some selected populations, the seroprevalence has been found. So this is the first study done in Sri Lanka to determine the prevalence of toxoplasmosis among the patients of schizophrenia, and our main aim was to determine the specific antibody prevalence with the and correlation between the presence of schizophrenia. So we planned case control study and sampling. We recruited 250 cases of schizophrenia. We planned to recruit 250 cases of schizophrenia and with age matched controls according to the sample calculations. Inclusion criteria was applied, and the consultant psychiatrist diagnosed schizophrenia according to the ICD-10 criteria, and we excluded all the major psychiatric diagnosis, and we selected the controls, age and sex matched, and with minor psychiatric conditions or even without any psychiatric diagnosis who were present into the psychiatric services for minor issues for the help. So interview administrative questionnaire was used, and we did we carefully separated the serum samples, and we did the rapid antibody testing among those blood samples. So I am here presenting only the preliminary findings of the study. We so far has recruited only 131 cases and 40 controls, and majority were males among those. So you can see clearly the antibody detection percentage wise was more among the cases when compared to the controls. So among the multiple risk factors we have studied, having a cat in the neighborhood was the most significant factor when compared to the positive and negative results. And the major objective that we needed to find was that the seroprevalence, and it has shown that the seroprevalence of toxoplasmosis antibodies has significant association with the schizophrenia compared to the control. So with this preliminary results, we can actually add it to the valuable scientific data that has been there in the literature, and further implications. Actually, if we can use simple measures like health education in order to prevent occurrences of this seroprevalence inside the bodies of pregnant mothers, like high-risk categories, we can aim for the prevention at least for these devastating illnesses. So limitations are still, those are preliminary data. We need further confirmation by recruiting, obviously, the larger numbers, as well as we suggest that if we can find the antibodies in the offsprings, and then we can do a longitudinal prospective studies in order to see whether they are going to develop schizophrenia or not. And with the advances of the technologies, we can study the NMDA receptor functionality with the neuroimaging in patients with schizophrenia with and without antibodies. We can further confirm these theories and look for the new development of drugs involving NMDA receptor pathways. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
How did you measure the presence of cats in the neighborhood?
It's by the interview administered questionnaire, sir, mainly from the patients and the controls self-report.
Were there any patients who did not have any cat in their neighborhood, for example?
Actually,
cats,
yes.
Are
yes, sir. There were some.
Some.
Yes, but it was highly prevalent in the both. It's
yes.
Very valid points, but there was significant difference with our results, but still in the preliminary stage. So that's the thing, sir. It's the risk factors are very, very prevalent, sir. So what we can do is probably the symptom measures like health education in order to prevent the occurrence of zero prevalence in the high risk category, sir.
Toxoplasmosis is actually, we consider it as a significant disease in immunocompromised people.
Yes, madam.
Yeah. So do you think that there's a huge component on this schizophrenia relationship, developing schizophrenia, just plain and simple toxoplasmosis somewhere in the body, for example, cervical lymph nodes or something like that?
Madam, the thing is, what we're looking at as schizophrenia may be a syndrome where we have some medication which are targeting for the dopamine receptors only has good response only a part of schizophrenia. So what we are looking at probably syndrome where these patients might have a different set of neurological involvement. That's why we studied only the zero prevalence. So it's antibody, if it is acting, then the antibodies must be acting on the NMDA receptor pathways. So it's not the clinical diagnosis of toxoplasmosis, but we are interested only on the zero prevalence of the antibodies.
Thank you.